Spring is here, and it's that time of year when Google holds its legendary Google I/O event to announce all the new features it's been working on, including the latest Flutter 3.32 and Dart 3.8 releases. In this video, we will explore exciting new features like hot reloading on the web, native iOS-style squircles for better visual fidelity, a smarter code for Mata, how your Dart code can even be shorter and more elegant, multi-window improvements for desktop apps, and much more. So, sit back and let's discover what's new in Flutter 3.32. We are kicking off this roundup of updates by highlighting an exciting new experimental feature in Flutter 3.32. Starting with this version, we can finally enjoy the Hot Reload feature for web applications. Hot Reload is clearly one of Flutter's greatest advantages for rapid development, and its previous availability only on desktop and mobile platforms was a limitation. That changes now, as this version introduces experimental hot reloading for the web. Let me demonstrate with this simple screen I've created. If I run it with a standard Flutter run command and make some changes to the code, then press the R key in the console, a hot restart is executed. This means the application starts from scratch and loses all its previous state. However, if I run this same application with the --web-experimental-hot-reload flag, make changes to the code, and press the R key again, the application refreshes instantly while preserving its previous state. This feature is especially valuable for large web applications where, without hot reload, you will need to repeatedly log in, navigate to specific screens, and restore your development context after each code change. Since this is an experimental feature, keep in mind that it may have some bugs. Nevertheless, it's a significant addition that will improve our development workflow. As Google typically does, this new version of Flutter comes with a new version of Dart, Dart 3.8. One of the features that will make your code more elegant is null-aware elements. This type of elements will make our code less verbose when adding items to collections like lists, maps, and so on. For example, here's how you will conditionally add elements to a list by first checking that they aren't null. Starting with Dart 3.8, we can perform exactly the same operation with this syntax. As you can see, these types of elements will make your code more readable and easier to maintain. By the way, if you're interested in Flutter, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Here I cover all the framework's latest updates, tutorials, and insightful interviews, like my conversation with Eric Seidel, Flutter's co-creator, where we had an in-depth discussion about Flutter's origins and where it's headed. So, if you haven't already, go ahead and click on that subscribe button now so you don't miss on any future video. One visually exciting addition to Flutter 3.32 is support for squircles, the distinctive rounded shape you see throughout Apple's iOS design. A squircle isn't just a rounded rectangle, it's a special shape that blends a square and circle, with curves that flow more naturally than simple rounded corners. This shape is part of the iOS aesthetic, and Flutter now supports it natively. This improvement means your Flutter apps on iOS can now look even more authentic, as both Cupertino Alert Dialog and Cupertino Action Sheet automatically use this new shape. The difference might be subtle, but it immediately makes your app feel more like a true iOS application. If you want to create your own squircle elements, Flutter now provides new tools for adding this shape to various UI components, whether it's for borders, clipping content, or custom painting. Let's talk now about another great improvement in Dart 3.8, updates to the formatter. In the previous release, Dart introduced a completely rewritten formatter with the new tall style. Now in Dart 3.8, they have refined it based on developer feedback, fixed bugs, and added even more improvements. One of the most useful changes is how it handles trailing commas. Previously, adding a trailing comma will force the surrounding structure to split across multiple lines. Now, the formatter is smarter. It first decides if a structure should be split, and then adds or removes trailing commas as needed. The formatter also improves how it formats function calls and assignments compared to the previous version. The improved indentation makes the code flow better visually and helps you understand the structure at a glance. Let's now talk about some new features that will affect you if you're developing a desktop app for Mac, Windows, or Linux. Flutter 3.32 brings significant improvements for desktop applications. First, there's better support for multiple windows, thanks to the team at Canonical. Previous issues with accessibility, keyboard events, text input, and focus management have been fixed, allowing you to create apps with separate windows for different functions, like a main window and additional windows for specific tools. Another important desktop improvement is thread merging on Windows and macOS. This enables your Flutter app to communicate directly with native platform APIs. For example, on Windows, you can now use native APIs to resize your application window or access other system features. These improvements are very valuable for building serious desktop applications with Flutter, especially those needing deep integrations with the operating system. Before we wrap up, here are a few more notable features in this release that are worth checking out. Firebase AI Logic is a significant update that lets you integrate Gemini AI directly into your Flutter apps using the official Firebase package, including access to the free tier for testing without any cost. Speaking of Gemini, it now speaks fluent Flutter and Dart in Android Studio, providing intelligent code assistance specifically tailored for Flutter development. For Android users, there's new stylus support that lets you write directly into text fields with handwriting recognition, similar to Apple Pencil functionality that was already available on iOS. And impeller rendering on Android continues to improve, with better performance and stability across different device types, especially for older Android devices. I have included links to the official Flutter and Dart blog post in the description below if you want to explore all the new features in depth. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and let me know in the comments which feature of Flutter 3.32 excites you the most. If you're interested in learning more about Flutter, check out this video where I interview Eric Seidel, Flutter's co-creator. It's a fascinating conversation that no Flutter developer should miss. Thanks for watching all the way to the end. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Goodbye.